Bats, as Janelle says, they kind of fly around. They're not the most popular animals in the Susquehanna Valley, but they're pretty beneficial for all of us.
On summer nights, bats eat countless mosquitoes and other insects, but bats are in big trouble, and you can help. Here's WGAL's Jack Hubley with tonight's wild moment.
Hi there, all you News 8 nature nuts. Normally, I don't talk about bats in the middle of winter when they're safely tucked away in caves. But there's a crisis in the bat cave, and that crisis can be summed up in three words: white nose syndrome. White nose syndrome gets its name from the white fungus that appears on the nose and other body parts of infected bats. It's a destructive fungus that awakens hibernating bats when they should be out cold. Stricken bats wake up, fly around, and burn up precious energy reserves. They often leave their caves in midwinter, and that's a death sentence to these insect-eating mammals. Just how deadly is white nose syndrome? Since it first appeared in New York in 2006, it's killed between 750,000 and 1 million bats in the Northeast, from Connecticut to West Virginia. People, that number's roughly equal to the entire bat population of Pennsylvania. We know that the fungus is spread through direct contact, which is bad news for these little mammals that huddle closely together during hibernation. So, maybe you're not interested in huddling closely with bats, but it's still important to have them nearby. A single bat can catch up to 2,000 flying insects in one summer night. Remember that next time you fret about West Nile virus while swatting a mosquito. Listen to this scary prediction from Game Commission biologist Greg Turner. I expect a majority of the bat hibernation sites in eastern Pennsylvania to have WNS by the end of April. So, what can we possibly do to help these valuable insect control agents? The Pennsylvania Game Commission needs our help to track this disease. If you find dead or dying bats on the landscape, or observe bats flying in the winter, please contact the agency right away. It's time that we all go to bat for bats. I'm Jack Hubley, News 8.
All right, well, as Jack said, the State Game Commission is asking, if you find a bat this winter, contact them. And we made it easy through a link at WGAL.com.
So what does Jack have for us next week? Some News 8 viewers have already seen robins, and they're wondering if that's a sign of
today.
Really?
Yes, I did.
It's bitterly cold out there. Is that a sign of an early spring? Well, Jack will have the answer for us in 7 days.
We hope.